Okay, now we will do the calibration for the 70 degree. This is the 70 degree single crystal probe. So, first we have to change the value for this 70 degree probe. First we will check the angle. Here angle is 0 degree. So, first we have to make this angle 70. So, we will come to this button and we will make this angle 70 degree. Okay, now this angle become 70. So, we will enter this button. Next, we have to check the mode. This is the 70 degree single crystal probe. So, we have to make the mode T plus R. So, we have made this now T plus R. Now, we have to check this probe 0. First, we have to make it 0. So, after pressing this probe button, we will come to this button and we will make this 0. Now it become 0. Again we have to check the delay. Delay is also 0. If it is not 0, then we will first make it 0. Next, velocity. This is the angle probe. So, for the angular probe, we have to make the velocity 3 to 30. So, we will change this angle to 3 to 30. So, now velocity is 3 to 30. For this 70 degree, we have to take the range 165. Here range is 300. So, we will make it 165. Again we will press here. So, it will change cursor and now we will make it 165. Okay, now this is 165. Now we will see rejection. This is 20, means okay. Now first we will make the gain about 10 dB. If it is not sufficient, then again we will increase the gain. So, we make the gain 8.5. For this calibration of the angular probe, we have to do the setting on this IRW block. So, this is the center and this arc is radius from this center to this arc is 100. So, we are sending the pulse from this location to this arc. So, beam path will be the 100. Here, we have to make the echo at the 100. That is the calibration. So, we have taken the range 165. Now, we will place this probe at this location and we will move forward and backward. When the echo is appearing, whenever the height of this echo is maximum, that time we have to stop this movement. So, for better accuracy, we can shift this gate at this, we have to touch the gate to that echo. So, we will get the location where the height of this echo is maximum. It is touching the 100%, means first we will decrease the gain. Okay, now this is the location. Here this is decreasing, now increasing, decreasing. Here this is the point at this location, height of this echo is maximum. Now, we have to see the beam path. This is the beam path. Here, this is the beam path. This is the radius. So, from this center, the radius will be always constant because this is the arc of this center. So, we have to make this beam path 100. So, for that purpose, we have to press first probe 0 and we have to change from 121.5 to 100. So, now this beam path is decreasing, we have to make it. First we will shift this gate. If range is 165, means that 165 is distributed into the 10 part. So, if range is, here beam path is 100. So it will come at this 6.1. So first we have to set this gate about this 6. Now we have to read this beam path. Now it is 1.6107. So we have to make this 106.7 to 100. Again we will press this probe 0 and we have to make it exactly 100, because our beam path is 100. So now when the height of this echo is maximum, that time our beam path should be 100. Now this 70 degree probe is calibrated for this range 165. So this is the calibration for the 70 degree. Okay.